Well, howdy space partners, Mr. Omniverse here, ready to blow your minds one more time. Today, we're asking a simple question. What would really happen if you took the ultimate leap from space to the moon? Would it be a graceful Superman-style landing? Or, something less superheroic? Let's break it down. But before we do, please remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon if you enjoy the video. Thanks, folks. You won't regret it. Okay, so let's imagine this. You're floating high above the lunar surface, gazing down at that beautiful cratered landscape below, and you get this wild idea, what if I just jumped? I mean, it's the moon, right? Low gravity, no air resistance, so nothing to slow you down, right? Surely it would be like floating down gently in a slow motion fall, like some kind of intergalactic feather, right? Well, hold up, my fearless friend, because you're wrong. So wrong. In fact, you couldn't be more wrong even if you tried. Let's talk about the moon. First off, the moon's gravity is only about 1/6 of Earth's. That's why astronauts can hop around like rabbits up there. Lower gravity, though, doesn't mean no gravity. So if you're falling, you're still picking up speed as you go. Now, here on Earth, you'd reach something called terminal velocity, a limit where you stop accelerating and just keep cruising at a constant speed. That's thanks to our thick, friendly atmosphere, which acts like nature's air brakes. But on the moon, nope. No air, no drag, no brakes. Just you and gravity. It's an all-out cosmic freefall. If you took a leap from, say, 100 meters up, which is about 328 feet, you'd hit the ground at a solid 37 miles per hour. Now, 37 miles per hour may sound like a fast bike ride, but believe me, hitting that rocky lunar surface at that speed would leave you in no shape to be doing astronaut poses for Instagram. Alright, let's say we get a little crazier. Imagine launching yourself off the tallest skyscraper. By the time you made it down, you'd be going over 115 miles per hour. Now, at that speed, you're not making a grand entrance. You're becoming part of the moon's landscape, like a very unfortunate boulder. But let's just say you've got a fancy spacesuit, the right breathing gear, and maybe even a helmet cam so we can all watch. But here's the deal. Spacesuits add bulk. You're basically a giant, overstuffed bag in freefall, so when you hit, there's no smooth landing. You're spinning, bouncing, and tumbling across the moon's surface. And you won't just stop, you'd keep sliding and bouncing like a cosmic tumbleweed. And every one of those bounces? It's another chance for something to go wrong. Even if the first hit doesn't break a bone or mess up your gear, each extra impact wears down the suit. Joints could snap, seals could break, and before long, your suit might start saying, "Yeah, I'm done with this." Plus, since there's no atmosphere or magnetic field on the moon, you'll be at the mercy of cosmic rays, solar radiation, and even the odd micrometeoroid. And don't forget about that pesky lunar dust. It'll get kicked up with every impact, floating around for way too long because there's no air to settle it down. I'm being overdramatic, sure, but if you breathe that stuff in over time, it can destroy lung and brain cells faster than you can say moon dust. So, while it might look cool in the movies, leaping onto the moon is more like a zero-gravity blender of bounces, bruises, and cosmic dust. And then, it'd be bedtime for Bonzo. Yes, that's right. You'd be Bonzo. So, my lunar-loving thrill-seekers, let's keep those moon landings to the professionals and make sure you're well-suited, well-prepared, and well, maybe just avoid jumping off anything too high. The moon is beautiful from up close, but it's not in the mood to play soft landing for any of us. I'm sorry, but the moon is not our friend. Also, did you know it's actually shaped like a lemon? But that'll be a topic for another video. If you've enjoyed this cosmic trip, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Until next time, this is Mr. Omniverse signing out. And remember, I'll always be watching you from the stars. I love you.